Respected Dean and heads of various departments, faculty members, and my dear newly admitted students. On behalf of the Eco Club of NIP Silchar, I, Dr. Malaya Dattavara, would like to welcome to the first day of Eco Club activities of Induction Program 2020. It will be a privilege for me to invite our Honorable Director, sir, to address the gathering. Sir, kindly.
All the BTech first year students who has joined NIT Silchar and who are present in the WebEx program of today's Eco Club initiating activity. I believe that some of you might have joined the YouTube channel also. Over and above, this is a large gathering. But obviously, our expectations, that is, as far as the mass tree plantation of the Eco Club activity that is going to happen, take place on this Sunday. All the 800 plus students, 876 total as of now. So all of you will be taking part there. So obviously, that will be a huge activity on part of the BTech first year students. Now, along with the BTech first year students, I also welcome today's speaker, Dr. Purnima Devi Bormon. Obviously, we would have been very happy to welcome her in our campus. And I do believe that once the corona pandemic is over, so she will be able to visit our place. And a nature lover that she is, so looking at the 625-acre big campus, almost 90% of which has been kept green, and only in the 10% of area we have the buildings and the roads basically, and the 23 natural lakes that are there, and that makes it a nice setting for an institute of higher learning, is where equal mixture or equal sensitivity to the environment activities are most important. Obviously, that is along with that green campus. So what I share with all of you is that we have 1 megawatt solar power plant, because say when we talked about in the orientation program, that was say when the 50% of the students have joined NIT Silchar, and the rest joined during the period of 25th November to the 2nd December. So for that, we made it a point to see that the orientation program event, we put that on the YouTube also, so that those students of us who could not join during the first part, that is the 16th to 21st November, for them the orientation program is there or will be there in the official YouTube channel of Ayush, make it a point to mute yourself when others are talking. Okay. Yes. So the orientation program is there on the YouTube channel as well. And the 15 odd induction programs that we started from 24th of November. So all of you, those who joined later on, you have the chances, or you are also taking part in those induction programs as well. And the taking part and the Eco Club activity obviously is one of those induction programs where all of you are getting part of. Now, as part of the induction program, along with the yoga, the mass tree plantation was another program, is another program in which all the students will have to take part. Had it been a normal situation like say the last year, so all the students, they physically planted the trees in masse in the campus itself. That itself is a mass movement kind of thing. So many students are being distributed across the big campus. And believe that for the last 50 years or so, this tree plantation program in the institute is going on. And still there are places where trees can be planted. And so, when you will be able to come back to the campus, so again you will be having a tree plantation program. So so that you plant a tree in your own name. Your template will be there. And after 4 years of your study here, when you leave, and during this period, you can nurture that tree. But this year, this tree plantation program assumes a different significance because you are now with your parents and near and dear ones. So whatever, whichever tree you are planting in the top or in your locality, whatever place you find it out. So when you will be not in your house and you will be, say, either in your hostel or later on, say, in your corporate life or, say, you will be moving elsewhere. So your parents will basically nurture that tree and will feel that my son or daughter was here. So the tree basically leaves such a kind of, the long-lasting relationship between human beings. Now, some bits about the environment friendly nature or the activities that we do. We do have a 1 megawatt solar power plant. Our street lights are powered by solar. And if you know, those of you who do not belong to the northeast part of the India, so there is abundance of sunlight. So that right from say 4:30 or 4:45 in the morning until say 4:30, so the long 12 hours strong sunlight we get in this region, so that the performance factor of the solar plate is say more than 55% to 60% basically, and that is something unthinkable in the northern part of India, and so the kind of environment that is here at culture as well as in the other parts of the northeastern part of India. So that is really unbelievable for those who have not made a visit to this place. Now, along with that solar power plant and the solar street light, we have solar water heater. So the different hostels, so in which you will be staying when you come back. And we were expecting that these solar water heaters will be inaugurated by you. That is when you'll be switching it on and taking, that is, don't feel the winter. Those solar water heaters are waiting for you to come to the campus to feel the warmth. And we do believe that in the near future, when the pandemic will be over and you'll be back to the campus of NIT Silchar. So there are a lot more things that large campus, green campus of this one, of NIT Silchar. And because of these academics as well as research as well as environmental activities, so I got an opportunity to speak in the fourth New York City Green School Conference. So I spoke about NIT Silchar, a green inspiring campus, and you can find that in the YouTube also. We had the opportunity to share, that is, how do we sustain? Because whenever you have a green campus, so the main problem becomes the sustainability problem. And the tree plantation, whenever guests arrive, they plant a tree in their own name. And so that when they go back, they basically take back not only the memory, but also the culture of planting a tree. So in this way, I think for the last 50 years or so, NIT Silchar has spread the message of mass tree plantation across the country, and why not across the globe as well, because our international visitors, they cherish this tree plantation program. In the recent past also, NIT Silchar has been identified as a member institute for the Sea Ganga project, that is Center for Ganga River Basin Management and Studies also. Because our institute, specifically the civil engineering department, they are doing a lot of work on the water resources and water pollution and other areas. And then in case of clean air mission, NIT Silchar is the institute of repute at the national level. So with all these activities, we are based on our past, present, and we are moving towards our future. And with this, so I once again welcome Dr. Bormon Purnima to our campus again. Whenever the time will be there, I think she will be able to meet us, and it will be a nice experience for all of us. And good evening to all our BTEC first year students and my colleagues as well. Thank you, Mala.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. Now, I would like to request Dr. Norris Babu, sir, technical coordinator, to play a recorded presentation about Eco Club activities. Norris Babu, sir, please.
Good evening.
Is it audible?
Honorable Director, sir, deans, faculties, guest speaker, Dr. Purnima Devi Varman, madam, and my dear friends. This is Arindam Khargoria, executive member of NITS Eco Club. On behalf of NITS Eco Club and your seniors, I welcome the batch of 2020-24 into the family of NIT Silchar. NIT Silchar is a jewel of exquisite beauty located in the northeastern horizon of India. The lakes reflect the rays of sun. The butterflies carry the dreams of the students. The flowers add freshness into the air. And the birds chirp their melody, providing a pristine backdrop for an effective learning in the land nourished by Borlui and Borak. NIT Silchar is also a scenic delight, with 19 lakes across the campus, trees all around, breathtaking views of hills nearby. The 628-acre campus echoes serenity, smiting everyone visiting the campus. In the next coming 10 minutes, we will try to take you to a virtual tour of the campus based on our theme, NITS, a green campus. Formed in 2016, NITS Eco Club is the environment wing of our institution. The club believes in the slogan, Green Campus, Clean Campus. Mastery Plantation is organized every year in August under the induction program of new batch and in March for the final year students. Art Day and World Environment Day are two most important environmental observances in the entire globe. In our campus, we organize cleanliness drives, plantation, installing signboards and banners to create awareness in the public and beyond. These are the photos from 2020 when we were locked in our respective places of residence. But our determination for service to Mother Earth was not willing to surrender before COVID. Faculties and members of the club planted a sapling with a hope for better days to come. Also this year, online competitions were held to reach out to greater audience. This included competitions of photography, article writing, quiz, and painting. These are the photos from the previous years when we celebrated World Environment Day and World Earth Day in the campus. We have a tradition in our college. Whenever a famous or respected personality visits our campus, they plant a sapling that stays as a testimony of their presence in the institute premises. In 2018, we were pleased to have with us Forest Man of India, Padma Shri, Shri Jadav Payeng. These are some of the more renowned guests visiting our campus in the recent years. This is NITS Nursery. It was established in 1979 from where we collect our saplings. We renovate the gardens in the campus, and Tranquil Garden is one of them. NIT Silchar is looking forward in being a self-sustaining campus. As a part of the mission, the campus has a solar power plant, solar street lights, and a biogas plant. On the occasion of 53rd Foundation Day, we train school students to make solar lamps. Once you return to the campus, please keep in mind the shops won't provide you plastic bags to carry your belongings. We have a complete ban on plastic bags in the campus and plastic cups in hostel and canteens. In order to achieve that, still cups are provided to students, which we have to carry to have a sip of tea in breakfast and in evening. This was the best out of waste program with the same aim, We also distributed jute bags as we try to create awareness among the public beyond campus. We also visited nearby schools to promote hygiene and sense of environmental awareness among the school children. Cleanliness drives are a common event in NIT Silchar. We do that on Gandhi Jayanti, Swachhata Pakhwara, and as a hostel cleaning event. We also organize seminars related to environmental issues, special drives on water conservation as a part of our mission. This was the cleaning of lakes near the girls' hostel. Though we have a biogas plant installed in the campus, still our aim is to curb food wastage till the level we could. We award the hostel with least per capita food wastage as an effort to reduce wastage of food. We install and also restore the dustbins in the campus. In NIT Silchar, we have dustbins in every nook and corner, and we expect the batch of 2020 to maintain the green temper by proper use of these dustbins. As a part of the beautification project, flower pots were installed in the newly constructed administrative building. We also try our best to promote reuse of plastic in the campus. Quickly sharing the pictures of the events from the past years. All these events were held in the previous years under the banner of NITS Eco Club. The places marked in red in the map are the places where our club has carried out plantation drives till date in the campus. We are a campus with exquisite beauty on the northeastern horizon of India. In the coming slides, we will have a look on the common flowers that adds freshness to the air of our college. This includes China rose, garden dahlia, crown of thorns, cardinal flower, orange cosmos, prince feather, morning glory, dog daisy, then Madagascar periwinkle, China rose, golden arrow, jungle flame, Chinese izora, cassia excelsa, weeping bottle brush, gulmohar, marble of Peru, cape jasmine, wild sage, pink water lily, Indian rubber. But this Indian rubber plant is not just yet another Indian rubber plant. The man who planted this makes it special. Yes, as a signboard suggests, it was planted by Bharat Ratna, former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, when he blessed our campus with his presence on 11th of May 2013, carrying with some more flowers that are found in the campus. This includes the Asian pigeon wings, yellow oleander, China rose, garden rose, Asian pigeon wings, Madagascar periwinkle, China rose, another species of that flower, love lies bleeding, then the birds in NIT Silchar carry our dreams, the dreams of the emerging minds, in their wings. Our campus has a rich avifauna within our periphery. This includes spotted dove, intermediate egret, little cormorant, common mynah, rock dove, pied mynah, hoopoes, Asian openbill, common raven, red-banded bulbul, chestnut-tailed starling, Indian whistling duck, yellow bittern, black drongo, blue algae, pine tree. These are the various butterflies that adds on to the freshness of NIT Silchar. These are the various types of grasshopper found in the institute. These are the various plants that adds to the beauty of the campus. Eco Album was a joint effort of photography club of our college in association with Eco Club that aims to showcase the floral and faunal diversity that exists within our periphery. As it is not yet launched, so we are unable to show you the entire album, but sharing some glimpse of that album. These are the photos from the flowers section of the album. This is from the avifauna section, and this is from the plant section. These are the people who work behind the screens to make this club one of the most active clubs of our institute. Coming on to the competitions that are going to be held under your induction program that are to allotted to NITS Eco Club. The first is the essay writing competition on the topic study of flora and fauna available in your locality with respect to utility and future prospects. The word limit is decided as 1500 words. It has to be typed and must be in English. And the file size should not exceed 10 MB. Last date of submission is 8th of December. And you have to submit it by a Google form. The link of the form will be mailed to your respective institute email IDs by Dr. Maloya Dutta Bora, Faculty Advisor, NITS Eco Club. For any further queries, contact your seniors whose numbers are given in the poster. Then comes the mast tree plantation. This is a compulsory event. Under this event, you have to plant a tree in your locality and send us a photograph of you while planting the tree. In case you live in a town or any urban area, planting a sapling in a tub, in a balcony or any other open space will be fine. It is too to be submitted via a Google form that is to be shared to your institute email IDs by Dr. Maloya Dutta Bora, Madam. The event is going to be held on 6th of December and you have to submit the file on, by 8th of December. The maximum file size should be 10 and can be in any kind of image format, JPEG, PNG or JPG. For further queries, contact the seniors whose contacts are provided in the poster. We also have an interactive session with two very eminent personalities working in field of environment, Dr. Purnima Devi Varman and Pradeep Kumar Goswami. After a few moments, we will have with us, popularly known as Hargila Baidu, Dr. Purnima Devi Varman. She is an she is a conservational biologist working with Aranyak. She is the winner of Whitley Award 2017, also known as the Green Oscars. She is also the recipient of Nari Shakti Puraskar 2017. Tomorrow, we will have with us Tridip Kumar Goswami. He is a recipient of the Carrot Award 2019 by Climate Action Reserve, Los Angeles. He is head of the compliance Sequest Capital, LCC, based in Washington, District of Columbia. Do join us in our journey. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Also like us on Facebook. Wherever you are, stay safe, stay alert. Follow COVID-19 protocols and together we will win this fight with COVID. Thank you.
Thank you, Arindam, for your presentation, and thank you, Naresh Babu sir, and thank you all. And now I would like to request Dr. Kulkarni sir, one of the program coordinator of Eco Club activities of Induction Program 2020, to introduce our today's expert speaker. Kulkarni sir, please.
Thank you, madam. Very good evening to Dr. sir, all my colleagues, and my dear students, and most importantly, our speaker, Dr. Purnima ma'am. And I thank Madam Dr. Maloya ma'am for such a nicely showcasing the activities of the Eco Club. And I am very sure that the students, the first year students will be very happy and enthusiastic about reaching the campus. And once they reach the campus, they will join us in making the green campus more greener and more sustainable. So now today we are fortunate to have with us Dr. Purnima Devi Varman ma'am. Basically, the whoever are working or whoever have the interest or inclination towards the sustainable development or the environment. So, madam needs no introduction, but I will have a brief introduction about ma'am. Suggested by this student representative, that is Kharboria, Dr. Purnima ma'am is known as the Hargila Baidu among the communities, and she is the conservation biologist, and she is also associated with the NGO called as Aranyak that is situated in Assam. Madam is a recipient of Whiteley Award 2017, Green Oscar Award 2017 for her crusading work in the conservation or the conservation movement to protect the highly endangered greater Argent stork, that is one of the species which is in the red list of the IUCN. So this was conferred to her by Royal Highness Princess, that is Anne, in London at Royal Geographical Society in 2017. Dr. Purnima has been conferred with Nari Shakti Puraskar by President of India, which is the highest civilian award for an Indian woman. Ma'am has awarded with several distinguished awards, including UNDP's India's Biodiversity Award, the Bank of Scotland RBS Earth Hero Award, as well as under this award was credited to her or conferred to her under the Special Species Category 2016, and also the Balibara Foundation, that is the Green Guru Award in 2016. Apart this, she is also a founder of a group called as the Kabila Army in a rural way, or in common tongue we may say it is the voice of a rural woman as a protector of a tree. And she has also organized more than 200 local women, or she has driven more than 400 rural women into this mission to raise the voice for the nature. Her work has given the community's voice, that she has set up a model for a community by building a strong ownership with all the women as well as the environment. Also a green teacher, diploma holder carrying a gold certificate in environmental education. Apart this, she has represented India at national as well as international platforms through the conferences, through the debate discussions, or through the various social events. The very few names of the country to mention, such as the starting from the developed nations like UK, US, to the developing nations or underdeveloped nations such as Cambodia. So she is a member of Global Women in Nature Network. So this network is basically enrolling or associated with the women who are working for the conservation of the nature or the biodiversity. And she is the director or the honorary director of the organizations being in India. That is the Women in Nature Network, that is WINN. Dr. Purnima has recently hosted an international conference for the working women or the women who are working in the environment area, right? So it was held in 2019 in Guwahati, wherein there were participants from all across the globe, mentioned to few, 13 countries in precisely. Also, Dr. Purnima is committed to serve the nature for the country last breath. That is what we understand from the commitment that she has already shown and she has presented. So with such a diverse and noble experience in the conservation of environment, biodiversity, and more importantly, the kindness toward the Mother Earth, we welcome you, ma'am, for this session, and we ask you to please enlighten our students with the importance of these things. Thank you.
Madam, kindly
unmute yourself.
Yes, madam. Thank you.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, madam.
Okay. So at first, thank you so much, Dr. Kulkarni, for all your kind words, and very good evening and namaskar to everyone present here. Honorable Director Sir and Dr. Malaya Datta Borua, thank you so much for giving this opportunity, and I'm so privileged to be connected with such a huge gathering. And yeah, it's really very encouraging, and I had goosebumps when I saw the all activities delivered through a presentation, all of your eco club activity, and I can feel how green the campus is, and I'm really excited to come very soon one day, and you know, and to meet all of you in person, and I hope it that day will come soon. So thank you so much, and thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to tell our Hargila conservation story from Assam. And if you all allow me, may I share my screen?
Yes, madam. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. I'm sorry.
Yes, madam.
Can you see my?
Yeah, about to come. Yeah.
It's about to come, ma'am. It's starting.
Can you see my screen? Oh, my presentation.
No. Open the PPT, madam.
Ma'am, open the PPT. Not now.
I have opened the PPT. So I.
No, madam, just you stop sharing.
Okay.
Stop sharing once. At the top, you can see. At the top, you can see stop sharing.
Yeah. Stop sharing.
Stop sharing.
I have a feeling that all my, you know, drives come.
Okay. There. Now open the, just open the PPT first.
Yeah.
Open the PPT.
I open only. It is, okay. Yeah.
Next, go to the WebEx, and there, then you click on share. Click on share. Click on share. There you can find your PPT. There are many windows.
Yeah.
You find the right window.
Yeah, I get my.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. About to come. Yeah.
I opened my presentation earlier also. I don't know why it didn't come.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. It's about to come, ma'am.
Yeah. No. Could you see my?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it perfect now?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. It is visible. Yeah.
Okay. You can start. Okay. Thank you so much once again, and sorry for the inconvenience. Okay. So today I'm going to share our people's movement in Assam. And so for that, as you all are know about our Hargila bird. So I just want to tell a bit about that Hargila bird, that is Greater Adjutant Stork, which is an IUCN Red List bird, endangered. So Greater Adjutant Stork, it's like it's as big, almost as big as my size. It's very tall bird, and it has a big wingspan, like 8 to 10 feet. It's such a, you know, and we are so, just imagine, we are so fortunate that we have such a, you know, such an incredible species in Assam, and so we are very blessed to work for this species. And so just a summary for this species, like, you know, its global population is around 1200 birds. And habitat loss, poaching, and poisoning are the major threats. And in 12 years of time, we could increase the nest numbers of this species by, you know, just by 8 times, especially the nest numbers and the population by double. And today I'm going to share this people's movement, our Hargila Army movement in Assam. And I am here, I'm here to team up with all of you so that we can carry on to contribute for this conservation movement. And first of all, before sharing my work, I would like to tell an incident or a story which happened 12 years ago. And this is like that, you can see, like, you know, like 12 years ago, actually, at that moment, my idea with this bird only to do my PhD, only to pursue my PhD and to be an academician, purely academician. I wanted to be a purely academician, but one incident changed my life. And so, and then I became, you know, my dream was to be a purely academician, but that after that incident, I think now I am very proud to be introduced myself as a proud member of Hargila Army or community member. And I am repeating again that I wanted to be an academician, but I became a manager, like managing people and people and people. And this way, you know, we all came up with a people's movement in Assam. And I think I have reason. I have a reason to share this picture because the very first day, when I was holding a baby bird, can you imagine? This is a baby bird of Hargila, Greater Adjutant Stork. It's more than 3 months, and you can see, you know, how it looks like an adult bird. And the very first day, actually that day when I was holding the bird, like, you know, that, a few people rejected to, you know, rescue. And when I was holding the bird, I had a goosebump, and I had goosebump, and I had a different feeling and inside calling for this bird. And I really want all of you, all the students present here, especially, to see wildlife on that way. You know, you all should have, you know, some deep connection or, you know, goosebump, you know, for this species. And we all should come up, we all should come forward with a scientific approach. And there might be a question, what was the incident, like, you know, which made me a human manager or, you know, just, or, yeah, so, or into this. It was like that. I was there in a village. I landed in a village to do my PhD, and one person cut down a huge nesting tree, kadam tree, and you all know about kadam tree. It was a huge nesting tree, and that tree was hosting 9 nests. And a person cut down a tree, and 9 nests fell down, and 9 baby birds fell down. And I was really embarrassed. It was for the first time I saw such an incident. And I dared to speak to the person, but he was very angry on me. And he had a reason also, because it was his own nesting tree. It was his own property. And he was very angry on me, and he said me, who are you to address me? Who are you? Actually, I think I was a very bad communicator at that time. I was an introvert, I think. I don't know, but yeah, I think I was a very bad communicator. He was yelling at me and mocking me, and then soon neighboring members joined, and all of them surrounded me and clapped at me and teased me and just started telling that, oh, you should come, and you know why this bird should leave. You know, this is a bad omen, this is a disease carrying messy birds, and you should come, you should join us as a, you know, as a housemaid and clean the debris and excreta of the birds. So why you should bother, and why this is a property of forest department, why should we bother? Please give us cash or something like that. And a few of them also left comments like, oh, this lady, I was trying to request them to help them to rescue a few birds and to transport them to a rescue facility in Assam State Zoo. And all of them started telling, oh, this lady would consume the meat of the bird, I think, on the way. And so they were basically, they were mocking me, but trust me, they didn't have any fault. We can't blame them. It was not at all fault, not their fault, and they were really very innocent, and they didn't know the importance of the species. I think that was the reason. I think it was my fault that I couldn't motivate them, and that day actually I got a purpose actually to live my life. I realized what I am going to do with my PhD. I couldn't actually, on that day when I was on the way coming back home, I realized that what I am going to do with my PhD, I couldn't even motivate a few people about the importance of the tree, about the importance of the bird, and what I'm going to do with my PhD, what is the value of my education. And at that day, actually, I got an insight call, and I thought that I would bring the birds into the hearts and minds of the people before doing my PhD. So this way, actually, I stopped or delayed my PhD. And from that day, actually, from the very morning of the next day, our mission started. And this way, I came into to work for this species. So that was the initial story that I wanted to share with you. And coming back again, like Hargila, I have already mentioned that more than 75% of global population is found in Assam. And I think it is very important to mention here that we all, everyone, public or policymakers, we are obsessed with mega species like, rhinos, tigers, elephants, and on that run, we always, neglect or we always ignore the other lesser known species. So I request everyone, I saw a huge gathering, so many participants here, so I request everyone to come up with a commitment to save everyone. If everyone come with a commitment to save one species, I just imagine how beautiful the world would be. So we must come together, unite together to save our lesser known species as well. And this is really very important. And here I also want to add that Hargila is an age bird recognized by Zoological Society of London, which is called evolutionarily distinct and globally endangered. And So I also wanted to share one of the very important, which inspires me a lot, very important picture. This is an art, and this is a painting which depicts the presence of Hargila bird in this year, in 1819. Just see. So this art really inspired me. But now we don't have Hargila anywhere except a few pockets. Hargila, the importance of Hargila, and you might have a question, what is the ecological importance of Hargila? Like, it is a carcass feeding cleaner bird like vultures, and they clean our environment, but people treat them as bad omen or messy birds, and people just cut down the trees when they come and breed. And I would like to add here that once the Hargila bird come and choose a tree for breeding, the tree becomes vulnerable. So we all should come forward to save the trees, the habitats of this bird. And once again, I would like to mention that on building ownership is so important, and community conservation, and tree owners or community conservation, communities are the key to protect this bird from extinction. From this picture, you just can imagine the exact story why this problem is happening. Actually, I have already told in my story also that this Hargila bird, they breed in the trees, which are basically the private properties. These are not government properties. So they breed in the tall trees, which are people's own property. And, and willingness and support of the tree owners is only the key to save their breeding habitat. So that is why it is very critical. The conservation is very critical, as it is a people's own property and people just cut down the tree. And so I'm going to tell more about this again. And yes, Hargila bird is protected under Wildlife Protection Act, and it is a Schedule 4 species. And but its breeding habitat is not protected. So we all must have to come forward to save its breeding habitat. So after that incident, in 12 years ago, we did a pre-campaign survey in all the colonies in Assam. Why the problems happening? Why people treat them as bad omen or disease-carrying pests or messy birds? And then we came up with some, you know, some answers like they treat them as messy, smelly birds, or you know, or many times the one of the most reason is that the greater resident stork has a high nesting. In other words, lots of baby birds fall down from the nest in the breeding seasons. Some are very small, or some are they look like adults also after 3 months. And when these are not attended, it become a headache for them. And many of the birds die also after falling down, or some of them some of them get injured, or even some of them die on the nest. Only so it becomes a headache for them. So you know, because earlier they didn't know how to rescue or and all, because once the bird dies, they feel that their campus get rotten. So these things, you know, these things made them a huge turn into a huge conflict between humans and the bird. And so this way, and many times they cut down the tree for land expansion also, and sometimes as an easy income source also. So these are some reasons. And most of the important thing that we experienced was that the villagers were not at all educated about wildlife, and they never knew that the greater resident was an important species. And so this way, actually, like one of the solution, it was such a huge conflict, which is really very difficult to explain even in a seminar, because, you know, it's after all, it's a community conservation, you know, we have to, and it's like it's just a huge conflict, you know, about may people come up with the complaining about the smell and all. So we it was a really very, you know, it's very, the situation was really grave when we started the work. And then we came up with a PR plan or a conservation movement in Assam. And then we started arranging or designing different education modules for different target groups, like for the tree owners, different target groups, for the school children. And we also started working with other stakeholders like forest department, police, and district administrations. And one of the most important solution that came was to integrate the bird into the traditions and cultures of people. That was the most important solution for this conflict. And this way, actually, we started our movement, and we started joining tree owners and meeting them and making friendship with them, understanding their concerns. Although these things look very normal, but these things so important to respect them, to build friendship with them, with the communities, to felicitate them in public meeting, to give them respect, and to continue the same. And we can't leave, you know, we just in the middle, like we have to continue the same effort. And this way, actually, we tried to rope in all the tree owners, and it was a huge, restless, unstoppable movement since the day we began. We don't have any Sunday, Saturday schedule in our work. Every time we are working for Hargila. And so then slowly and slowly during my work, we formed a group called Hargila Army, all women army team. And can you imagine how many women are there now in our Hargila Army movement? We have more than 10,000 rural women as our Hargila Army. They believe that they believe that this is one of the most most respectful platform for them, because earlier our women, our rural women who are basically homemakers, they didn't know that they have a role. They have a role towards wildlife or towards, you know, towards conservation. But now they feel so respected, and every day more than 30 to 50 women, they call us and want to join Hargila Army and to contribute. So this is, I think, really huge honor for us and responsibility also. And now that is why now we are a very big team. So I have a feeling that I am. Can you see my presentation?
No, madam. No.
Can you see my presentation?
No. Please share, madam.
Oh, what happened? Since when it happened?
Just now, miss.
Okay. Yeah, I have shared. Did it come?
Yes, about to come.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So if it happens, please let me know. Yeah. So our work is an integration of science, awareness, education, pride, empowerment, protection, rescues, and tradition. And I think conservation should be a package of all these things. So let me start again. Carry forward. So, and like this way, actually, we started our movement. And when these women, our women didn't like to come to the meeting, mostly their male members of the family came, and our women didn't like to come to the meeting first. And so we had a different module in our education. We incorporated these traditional food, you know, festivals or food competition in our environment education modules. And as I am a green teacher from CEE, Center for Environment Education, so I learned lots of environment education games and, you know, modules from them. And these were really very helpful. And one of the most important environment education games, which I always, you know, want to share with you. And I request all the students or all the students or organizer from Eco Club, you also can do it among your students or in your model village or communities where you are working. So this is Wave of Life. And in this education game, our women or anyone who plays this, they give a strong voice and they share a lot. And this way we started bringing more and more people to our movement. And we have a program called Communities Teaching Communities, and we have a drama group among the women. And this Communities Teaching Communities is one of the biggest hit, because rather than I keep going, so if we educate a group, our women group or educate a group, then they keep going and they educate the other groups, then they educate, they become, they make some other groups as another groups who again keeps going. So this way, actually, we have a huge team and we all are working together. And we also have pride campaigns, organized pride campaigns. And this is really an effective tool. And you also can, if you want to, you know, work for some species, you know, you also can do such, you know, organize such pride campaign with your communities or anyone you want. So, and I want to request, I want, this is an opportunity to invite everyone from NIT. So next year, I really invite all of you to attend our Stork Baby Shower. And I'm sure you have not attended Hargila Baby Shower before. And it is exactly like, you know, and I have a story to share with you. When I started this movement, we found that most of the time the tree owners often cut down the trees or the birds were disturbed or sometimes people put smokes under the nesting trees. So and that time was so crucial because that was the breeding time. So we came up with a different solution. We started organizing Hargila baby shower, Ponchamrit ceremony. Exactly like the way we celebrate for our Assamese expecting mothers, And following the same rituals, we started celebrating Hargila baby shower. And our women, actually, I really request all of the students present here, please be very innovative. Always try to be very innovative and creative, and really, yeah, you know, and this really have a this really gives a result. And so, yeah, our women really loved it. And earlier they laughed, but once they came and they saw the event, like, you know, and it was so participatory because it was not like a seminar for them. It was their own program, but we are creating awareness about the storks, and they give him for the increase of the population. And now we do not need to tell them, do not cut down the trees. Generally, what happens when we keep going visiting and give them a lecture, do not cut down the trees, or save the habitats or something like that, they do not listen much, you know. So we have to, that's why we came up with a different solution. And our women, they became so participatory for this event. And now we don't need to tell them about that. They now, you know, they start their, you know, just, yeah, their own programs, and they do the needful now. So this way, actually, we don't miss any opportunity to create awareness everywhere. We create awareness, like in prayer halls, in paddy fields, everywhere we create awareness. And it was, as I have mentioned, it was an unstoppable movement. And also the village Gita Bhagavad procession, this was one of the biggest program in our journey. And every year we celebrate this kind of event. And the villagers have their own Gita Bhagavad procession, where more than 10,000 people come to the street and join. And we march with the committee, we team up with them, and we celebrate the beauty of Hargila and create awareness. And this way, and I think it gave a more impact. Earlier, Hargila was treated as bad woman, and then, you know, it was a transformation that Hargila came into the Gita Bhagavad procession. I think it was a huge success. And so our work is not only saving this bird, but also empowering women, which is so important, and also social changes in these villages. And as you have already mentioned about our Whitley Award, so after Whitley Award, we could do many things, more things that I couldn't do before. So thanks to the Whitley Award, and so we could establish a weaving facility in the village, and our women could come up with many products, march our traditional attire, our respectful gamosa with this bird. And trust me, this gamosa with Hargila is so hit. People from all over the world, they want a Hargila gamosa, and they really want it, and it really means a lot. And you can see our respected, beloved Hargila Army women here, who really looks very, you know, who really, yeah, they who really seems very happy. And this way, actually, our women not only sell the attire in a good price, but also share their pride. And also, you know, it is so important to. I always strongly believe, and I'm sure you will support me, because our in villages or in rural areas, our women have these skills. But nowadays, due to urbanization and all, our people have stopped those skills and forgot those skills. But I really want them to carry on these skills and to create magic. So here, I also want to add that we also gave offer them diploma, fashion and technology diploma, and especially to weave Hargila motif into their attire. And this way, actually, our women started creating magic in their attires, and Here I have a reason to share this slide with our very one of the very inspiring Hargila Army, Sangeeta. She is a youth, and at this age she is supporting her family and Dishu, and she weave many things, and Dishu actually she is also creating conservation message to the world. And so we also help our women to link up with markets. And nowadays, all of our women's products are available in some online website also. And again, I'm very thankful to our New Zealand High Commissioner, Madam Mrs. Joanna Campers, and she was really very kind and helpful, because she offered us a grant, and through this grant we could support 80 sewing machines to our women, and this was really very helpful for us. And I'm very honored to share this picture with you of my mentors. I have many mentors across the world, and two of them are Simon Stewart and Kira. Both of them are from IUCN. And also at the same time, I would like to mention that our attires or this just clothes with stork motifs, these were so popular actually. And with this also we created like conservation awareness in the globe. And during the pandemic time, also in the lockdown time, and during the pandemic time, our women could come. We supported them to weave to produce face mask and all. And you can see, and more than 11,000 face masks were distributed in the communities. And nowadays, and many people from all over the world, they want these face masks. And our women are working hard on this. And so these are some, during the pandemic time, how our women are working. And also I want to share, these are some pictures from earlier years. I also want to share here, if you have a project to work with communities, I always request everyone, please do not go with cash. For example, one tree owner is supporting a tree. If we give them direct cash, it is not sustainable at all. And because we don't have that resource, maybe one time we have a project, we can give them, but it will not be a sustainable solution. Then next year or after that, misunderstanding happens, and lots of problems happens. So it happened earlier in some case studies. So after learning that, we always came up with a solution to give scholarship, to support scholarship, and to be very honest and transparent, telling them that this is a one kind or two time, sorry, one time or two time scholarships. Otherwise, giving direct cash, sometimes, working with people is the toughest challenge. So we always try to avoid giving direct cash. But instead of it, we try to give them rewards or in-kind supports. Like we saw that we give them sewing machines or looms and all. So also we work with children, young champions, and we are also establishing a Hargila Learning Center in our village in Posoria, Kukhalkor High School, and it will be launched within this month. We are going to inaugurate our Hargila Learning Center and Museum. And I am sure I'd be very glad if some students join us and contribute to our Hargila Learning Center through your skills if you have any skills like art or environment education, songs or any advice support, you can support us. So These are some crafts classes which we convert, these are some craft class which we convert to Hargila craft class in schools, local schools, and these really are very, I think these things give a very big touch and factors for creating awareness. And so we also work in with the rag picker children in the garbage dump also, and we try to work as much as possible with our limited resource. And we also try to create awareness through puppetry. We have our team member Drisana Kolita, who is an expert in puppetry, and this year we try to create awareness for not only Hargila but as a whole for nature. And here I also want to add that there is an international group called EBON, Artists and Biologists Unite for Nature. I'm very privileged that 2 years ago they offered me themselves, they called me, and they gifted more than 80 paintings for our Hargila Learning Center. And I'm very sure in next of my presentation, I would love to show our Hargila Learning Center with all these paintings and all. And this is one of the few glimpses of our Hargila Learning Center, but now it is almost completed in a local school. And for this, we have selected a government school, and we are going to donate this Hargila Learning Center to that school, and we'll carry on our conservation education movement from that Hargila Learning Center. And this is Dr. Kulkarni introduced about Women in NASA Network. Yeah, we are working with this global group also. And when we hosted this conference in 2019 with women from many countries, more than 13 countries, and our community women also a part of this Win India conference, and it was really a big sense of awareness for all of them. And most importantly, Hargila was a symbol, was a logo of this awareness. And also we have Kamrup Police as our partner, district administration our partner, who is really is a matter of pride for all of our communities. They really feel very good. And recently, what's happening now with our, in our conservation project? Now this week we are celebrating Happy Hatching Week, and tomorrow we are going to celebrate another Happy Hatching ceremony, because the Hargila birds are hatching now. They have hatchlings, and during this hatching ceremony or during this hatching period, we had Diwali very recently, and the Hargila had babies. So we tried our best to in the nesting colonies with all our women and communities to stop crackers near the nesting colonies. And for this I'm very proud, very honored that Kamrup Police SP, he himself visited with us and himself moved in our e-riksha campaign, and it was one of the biggest successful event. But yes, of course, we all in these things we always have challenges. Yeah, and as I have mentioned that we never miss any opportunity to create awareness. So we create awareness in every event, even in like Republic Day or Independence Day, we try to create awareness and requesting district administration, and they are really very helpful and support us. And this is a Hargila corner in DC office, in Deputy Commissioner's office, who is also create awareness, and very thankful to our DC Kamrup. It is his idea. He only offered this idea, and we established this Hargila corner at his trees. And we also put nets under nesting trees. This is the hatchling season, as I have mentioned about our happy hatching. So this is the baby birds are born, and they fall down also. And in on the month of January, February and March, we are so stressed. Actually, we are so stressed. The birds fall like anything, and we put nets under the nesting tree. And this was a picture of earlier years, but this time in coming weeks, we are going to install the nets under the nesting trees, and the birds fall down in the nets, and then we rescue them and transport them to Assam State Zoo. And then, yeah, one of the rescued birds I wanted to share with you. And so, and then these are the baby birds, you know, you can see, and the birds fell down on the nets. And then we, during the time of release, after hand raising, we put rings on their legs, and then we release them in the wild. And for this, I'm very honored that we have so many people, you know, coming forward to help. We have teams like, you know, from veterinary department and Zoo, Assam State Zoo. So all of them come together, and we all work together for this. And so this, because many students are here, so I wanted to share this picture with you. When the birds fall down, we try to do post-mortem with as many as birds we try to do, and with the support of veterinary department. And in some of them, results are very very sad. You can see in some of the postmortem we found iron nails, animal hoof, or unusual materials in the stomach, and and plastics also. And we really need to change our, you know, I always want to say that, you know, before changing others, we really need to change ourselves first. So these things, you know, always comes to birds or animals, you know, stomach. So we have to be very careful on that. But yeah, but we need to, I think, work on segregation also. And I request many students are here. I request all of you, you know, to work together on that aspect also. And yeah, we all can do. And every day we blame government, but I think we have much role on that also before blaming others. So I just wanted to share my views. And yeah, we are also studying egg cells of this Hargila bird to see the heavy metals, heavy metal status also. For this, my guide, Professor D.K. Sharma, he is helping me. I am not very expert on that, but sir is really helping me a lot. And so these are some status, and we are also studying the electron microscopy of egg cells. I think I don't need to share this much. And again, at this topic, my guide is helping me. And for investigating the breeding behavior, I completed my PhD finally last year. And for doing my research and for the future other more studies, I climbed this bamboo platform, I have 3 bamboo platforms every year, and one of them is around 100 feet, and one of them is 85 feet, and the other is a different size. And I stay there in the bamboo platform and for many days and study the breeding behavior of the bird. You can see my bamboo platform. And yeah, for this also, I got a training in Prag 12, Cambodia, where I could access 28 such bamboo platforms and study the birds in Cambodia, Hargila bird gate resident. And yeah, I just wanted to share with you that. And now this is another story which I think very important to share with you. And this is very inspiring for me. This is actually a success. And when people ask me, what is the definition of success? I think this is one of the definition of success. In 2017, after I got Whitley Award, I came up with an experiment with the artificial platform for the artificial breeding platform for the Hargila. And yeah, a few conservationists told me that it will not work. They will not choose, but you can see the result. First year in 2017, they built a nest, but they didn't hatch. But I didn't lose the hope, because they built a nest. They didn't hatch though. And next year in 2018, you can see our baby birds in the artificial breeding platform. And then we started this in Assam State Zoo also, with support from Assam State Zoo in Hargila birds. And there also we had 2 babies. But after 2 months, the birds died in the zoo. But here in the wild in 2018-19 we had baby birds, and this year also, you know, this year is more inspiring because in one bamboo platform where there are you know, in a single bamboo platform we have now two pairs which have hatched, and yeah, there are babies, and it's, I think it's time to celebrate. And yeah, so, and so this is so inspiring from the artificial breeding platform, and I think that our students would love this. And yeah, so results are rewarding. We have challenges, but results are rewarding. Tree owners developed ownership feeling, which is so important in conservation, developing ownership feeling. Ultimately, why we are working, this is the main thing, I think, to develop ownership feeling among all of us, winning the hearts and minds of the people. And Dodora Postura Singimari Village, where we are working now, is the you know, largest breeding colony in the world, and this colony is globally recognized as safe haven for the birds, and nest numbers increased by 8-folds, and from 2010 not a single tree was cut down. And so these are some status. And yeah, I just our students or every one of you, I think you all might have a question like how you can join us. I have already mentioned that you can join to our activities, to our Hargila Learning Center. If you want, you can come and meet our women, encourage them, you know, meet our communities and encourage them, or any skills, you know, you know, it's, I think you can think like how you can help us, and you know, how you can you know, team up with us and give your skills to our conservation movement. But here I really want want one of your suggestion. Last week I went to Morigaon district, and now we are specially working in Kamrup district, and then we from last year we started working in Morigaon district, and there are three trees there which are really very vulnerable. Last week I had a visit, and I was not informed by anyone. I just visited. I don't know why, like, again, that story I told you 12 years ago, again, that came, like, I just went to that, to an area called Lothabari, and I was there, and I saw that one, you know, a few people came there, and they started cutting down trees, and the third tree which they were targeting was a nesting tree of Hargila, and the fourth target was also this huge tree that I showed to you. And this tree, last year we found that this tree had the highest nest in entire, I think, world. We found 23 nests in one single tree. And the person, I think the person's target was the third tree, which is on the right side. And they told that they got, they have to, you know, build house and all. So I think so. We are already, you know, we already working so hard, and now again, yeah. So I think when Hargila bird come to a tree, I think these trees become vulnerable, and I think all of your strong voice can be really very helpful for saving these trees. And if we all can come together, and I think write to the Morigaon district, or you know, or we you know, or more than that, if we all, you know, write a letter, or if an eco club can write a letter to the tree owners and the district commissioner to save these trees. I think this tree is so important. It's such a huge, having more than 18 nests, and yeah. So, but the good news is that when we approach them, they understood, and they ensured that they would not do it until the birds stop breeding. But after that they also were showing some problems and all, but yeah, they ensured us. But still, I really want your strong voice, not only to save these trees from Morigaon, but for all the trees in Assam, because students' voice is so, I think, so strong and so important. So yeah, and two words, I think one word which is green, the word green, which is very which is one of the beautiful word for me. If someone asks me which is the most beautiful word which inspire you, then it would be my word would be green. And apart from that, if another word people come, people come with a question, if what is the another word that you love apart from green is optimistic. So I am really very optimistic. It is Hargila conservation is really very challenging, but I am really very optimistic, and I think we all are very optimistic. And for conservation, I think we all have to be optimistic. And I don't know how. I think it is the last slide, but still I can't move. Yeah. So I'm very thankful to all our donors, all our supporters and villagers, district administration, police, and Whitley Awards, and everyone, Assam Forest Department and villagers, our Hargila Army women, everyone, a big thanks, and all of you for giving me this opportunity to share our Hargila story. And thanks a lot, everyone, and let's be very optimistic and positive, and together, I think we all can make a difference. Thank you so much for listening to me, for your kind listening. I think I'll stop sharing my screen now.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, madam. Yes. Okay. Thank you, ma'am, for your motivational talk about conservation of Hargila Ward. So we are looking forward for your same support in the future event as well, madam. Thank you, our director, sir. Thank you, faculty members. And thank you, my dear students, for being here. Once again, thank you. Thus, I want to say, dear students, you are requested to fill the feedback form, which is posted in the website. So, tomorrow we'll meet in the same platform at the same time. Director, sir, kindly permit us to wind up this session, sir, kindly.
Yeah, so thank you. And thanks to Dr. Poornima for showing us the passion that she has shown. And I think the passion that has been spread to our colleagues, our women team members, and the passion that she has been able to spread among the students, among us also. So whatever kind of activities we do with this kind of passion, then and then only we can make a big difference to the society. Thank you again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everyone. Namaskar. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all. Students, you are requested to fill the feedback form.
Feedback form already shared, madam.
Yes.
Madam, I'm closing the meeting.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.